This is the CL-289, called the USD-502 by the NATO armies that use it. The whole system was developed by Canadair in partnership with Dornier of Germany. SAT of France later joined to furnish an infrared sensor, as well as this radar, which was used to track the remotely piloted vehicle during development. Like all battlefield systems, the 502 has to be fully mobile. The basic vehicle is mounted on a rail launcher. It takes just minutes to attach the wings and control surfaces, then conduct the pre-flight check. On an operational mission, no radar is used, and the USD-502 flies a computer-controlled trajectory according to an accurately worked-out flight plan. Then the launcher is adjusted to the correct bearing and elevation. The small turbojet of 240 pounds thrust is started up and run up to speed. When all is ready, the firing button is pressed. The rocket blasts the vehicle off the ramp, and the burnout drops away to the rear. What is left is a small, agile, hard-to-detect, and very fast aircraft, cruising at about 500 miles per hour. On board are navigation and control subsystems, which would do credit to many manned aircraft. They enable the vehicle to follow a flight plan worked out in exact detail. A typical sensor pack has a three-lens Zeiss camera and an infrared line scanner, both giving image resolution as good as that from a larger and more vulnerable manned aircraft. Real-time pictures are sent back by secure digital links so that the ground commander can study the enemy's activity without delay. The computer not only handles navigation, it can also manage the sensors. To reduce vulnerability, this tiny jet aircraft can even hug the ground on a quasi-terrain following mode. On return, it detects and homes on a beacon near the launch site. A signal deploys a two-stage parachute. The CL-289 descends inverted and lands on two large airbags that cushion the impact. It's quickly recovered and driven away to be refurbished for another mission.